Hello there, lovely people. Welcome back to Jerry's Debug Recipes. Savory, sweet, spicy, and crispy. There's no better way to describe the Korean fried chicken. Let's quickly get to preparing this amazing dish. Before we start, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel for new awesome recipes every week. I'm going to be using 1 kg of boneless chicken thighs for this dish. First, we're going to start by marinating the chicken with pepper and salt. Mix everything well together and set aside for about half an hour. The reason I prefer using chicken thighs is because it does not dry out as quick as chicken breasts. Once the chicken is marinated, add in the all-purpose flour, the potato starch or corn flour, the baking soda, and 2 eggs. Mix everything well together. Make sure to coat the chicken well with the mixture. Cover and set aside for about 10 to 15 minutes. In that time, we can start heating up the oil for deep frying. Once the oil is heated up, place in the chicken one at a time. Make sure to keep a check so that they don't stick to each other. Now, what makes the Korean fried chicken really crispy is that it is double fried. For the first round, let it fry for about 10 minutes. Once the chicken has turned golden brown, you take it out of the oil and place it on a cooling rack. Time to start the second round of deep frying. This time we're going to fry it for about 6 to 8 minutes. This should do to work the magic of making it nice and crispy. When the chicken is fried only once, it tends to get a bit soggy, and that is why it is necessary to fry this one more time. Look at that lovely color. Looks like it's starting to get crispy. Now I'll be taking it out of the oil. And I'm going to start preparing the sauce for this chicken. The sauce is what gives that lovely sweet and spicy flavor to this fried chicken. I'm going to start by heating up some oil in a wok, add in some garlic, and saute for a bit. Some gochujang, or Korean red chili paste. Some tomato ketchup. About 3 teaspoons of vinegar, some honey. Give everything a good mix and let it cook for a minute. Turn off the flame and now it is time to add in the chicken. And give everything a good mix. Now to top up the flavor to the next level, garnish with 1 tablespoon of toasted sesame seeds. And looks like we're done. I'm going to plate this. You can serve this dish along with some pickled radish and some delicious kimchi. Let's give that a quick taste. Now that is really one crispy and delicious fried chicken dish. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. Thank you for watching until the end. Until next time, God bless.